Okay, so the reason we're stopping here, this is basically just the topograph showing us how far you guys are away from your place of origin. You guys being main majority from the United States. We have a few guys from
Cape Town.
We're in Cape Town.
Just here
in Cape Town. Okay. Nonetheless, you guys from the States, which would be closer to you guys? New York, Washington?
All of them. New York, Washington.
This guy from Chicago, he says Chicago is much closer to him. That's about 13,663 kilometers away from here. San Francisco, that's about 16,400.
Los Angeles, right?
Los Angeles, that's 16,050 kilometers away. So the gentleman from Chicago, it's actually much closer to home than you guys. But the people who's even closer to home than him would be the guys from Cape Town. Okay? They don't even have a number on the map. They basically have an area code on the map over here. Okay? So basically, New York, that's about, you actually win Chicago. That's about 12,562 kilometers away from here, okay? And majority of Cape Townians actually comes from the Cape Flats area over here, which is the flat area. And in Cape Town, they say it's called Die Kaapse Vlakte. Okay, which basically is an Afrikaans or a Dutch term, which translates to flat lands. Okay, and during the apartheid era, many non-white people were moved from places like Boerkaap, where you find the colorful houses at the foot of Signal Hill. They were moved from places like District 6, Constantia, and so forth, and they were forced to places like Khayelitsha, which is predominantly a black township, and it is also considered to be the biggest township in Cape Town area. Okay, they were moved to places like Langa, which is considered to be the oldest township in all of South Africa. Okay, so those were two predominantly black townships because segregation was basically big back in that time. So people of different race were not allowed within the same communities or areas. So people of colored descent, okay, or colored was just the term which the apartheid government brought in. So people of Khoi descent, of Cape Malay descent, they were basically moved to places like Mitchell's Plain, Blue Downs, the southern suburbs areas, and so forth onwards, guys, okay? And also during the apartheid era, black people were, only black people were basically issued with a pass, okay, which limited them from traveling between place to place. And if they were traveling between place to place and any authority stopped them, they would basically be asked for this pass as well as a letter or something to state why they are traveling between place to place. Okay, guys, lovely stuff. Then I told you guys Table Mountain National Park stretches from Lion's Head all the way up to Cape Point or Cape of Good Hope, okay? And do you guys know what Cape Point is popular for? Okay, a lot of people mistake the Cape of Good Hope or Cape Point for being the most southerly tip of the African continent, as well as being the place where the two oceans meet. But that is unfortunately inaccurate, okay? Cape Point, it's basically the place where the first European settlers settled along the South African coastline, okay, as well as it's the most southwesternly tip of the African continent, the most southernly tip of the African continent, and the place where the two oceans meet. It's about, say, 2.5 to 3 hours outside of Cape Town by a place called Cape Agulhas, and that's more along the east coast of Africa, okay. So the reason why people mistake Cape Point for being the place, okay, you basically have the Atlantic Ocean on the west side of Cape Town, as well as on the east side of Cape Town. So this, the west side, it's called the Atlantic Seaboard. The east side, it's called the False Bay Coast, okay? So the water on the False Bay Coast, it's much warmer because it's much closer to the actual meeting point of the Indian Ocean, okay? Then the Atlantic Ocean on the west side, it's much colder because of the Antarctic icebergs, which I explained to you guys. So by the time it meets up at Cape Point or Cape of Good Hope, it basically has a milder temperature. So in actual fact, it's not the two oceans which meets over there, but it's the two undercurrents of the oceans. So it's the cold Benguela current and the warm Mozambique current which basically meets up at Cape Point over there. Okay, guys? Is there any questions with regards to that?
No. Stuff.
Then around over here, this is basically just the different types of plant species which you can find at the top of the mountain. The Protea family over there being South Africa's national flower, the King Protea, okay, as well as our cricket team, the one on the end, that's the King Protea. So that's South Africa's national flower. It normally blooms in the winter months, so it's very rare to spot a King Protea this time of the year. However, you will spot other Proteas like the Pincushion or the Oleander Protea, okay? So our cricket team is also named after the Proteas over there. Okay, guys? Lovely stuff. So we're going to take a walk around this way.
Oh.